Zombies can be dangerous for you, but not because of the zombies. Now I know what you're thinking, what the hell are you on about? Well, I'm talking about the environments that we put ourselves into each time we load into a zombies game. I mean, have you seen the dangers around? Broken buildings? Fires all around the place? Chemical gases in the open air? That's just to name a few things you must worry about. But don't worry, as your qualified safety instructor, I'm here to go through each map and rate them based solely on their safety. So to do this, I have come up with a not so complicated formula, he says sarcastically, identifying 21 types of hazards ranked between 3 tiers, low, medium and high. So I will go around checking the frequency of these hazards and giving each one a score, and at the end of the map I will combine these to get an overall score out of 100. Where it will then be placed into a tier list and ranked against other maps as we go along. On top of this, there will be 2 additional tiers, which will be a miscellaneous tier for hazards such as dragons being on a map breathing fire at you, Garrod, and safety, where if the map has any of the listed safety features, it will get bonus points to its score. Anyway, now that we have the complicated rules out of the way, let's get down to Nacht der Untoten. Hello, the safety inspector is here. Just in the nick of time by the looks of things as well. I'm gonna need some gum for this because I'm kinda hungry. Right, where do we even start on a map like this? There's a lot going on to start with. But I think our main issue that I can see straight away is there are way too many tripping hazards around this place. I mean, you have got this massive thing here. You could fall straight over this. All this pile of rubbish and rocks all over the floor. That's a tripping hazard. That's a tripping hazard. That cable's definitely a tripping hazard. That massive sandbag could be a tripping hazard. There's a massive flickering light on the floor that could be a tripping hazard. And there's another massive pillar sticking out the bottom here that could be a tripping hazard. So I feel like we have discovered the first risk. So I feel like it's a good idea that we chuck on tripping hazards onto our checklist. It is a low rated risk, but I feel like due to the amount of tripping hazards that are around, it's going to be somewhere towards the higher end of the risk category of the lower tier. So I'm going to give it a 75. Okay, now that we've identified a massive amount of tripping hazards everywhere, let's try and avoid those and move on to see if there are anything else that we could cover. Now, one of the things that's standing out to me around this area is that there's a massive hygiene issue here. I mean, we've got lots of blood all over the walls, all over the floor. We've got people walking through it by the looks of it with the footprints. I mean, that's not good. It's all over the walls here, handprints. So people have actually got blood all over their hands now, which could contaminate even more stuff. And I believe it was all over the door when we first looked at it as well, which isn't good. Again, lots of blood all over the walls, splattering all over the floor. Massive piles of blood as well. That cannot be good for you. And again, we've got even more blood all over the floor. And if I'm honest, this floor doesn't look like it's been swept in a while either, let alone mopped. There's also dead bodies with axes on it. That is not good for hygiene. So this is going to be our second risk found on this map. Hygiene, again, we've put in the low tier category, but I can't say that it is very hygienic at all. So it's gonna get a rating of 70. Moving on, I think I found another hazard. There are a lot of little bits and bobs like cans that are clearly rusting. You've got little shreds of rock everywhere. You've got broken lights all over the floor, which means there's glass everywhere on the floor as well. That is a lot of shrapnel on the floor. Now, there is, like I said, shrapnel all over the floor, the likes of glass and whatnot, but it doesn't seem to be causing a major issue. So we are going to be giving this, since it is a low tier risk, it's going to get a rating of 90. Not too dangerous, but it is still a risk. While we're here, let's just have a little box spin, see what we get. See if this can help us with our risk assessment. Oh, this could help. Oh, this could be a bit of an issue in the workplace. Fire inside a building. That's not a good look. See, this is what happens when you leave unattended torches everywhere. They fall and they break, and then you have fire. Someone could easily burn a hand on this. Now, whilst we do have 2 tiers of burns, I wouldn't say that these are big enough to cause high-grade burn. So I am going to class this as a low-grade burn, meaning that it's going to fit once again into the low-tier risk. And it's not anything massive. It's 2 couple spots that could be easily put out. So I'm going to give it an 80%. The next issue I have with this map is there are a lot of holes in the ceiling. which means there is a possibility that if you're walking around here, you could fall down. We don't want people falling down if they are busy fighting zombies. That could hurt them and cause them potential death if they get caught when they fall. Now, whilst this is a medium risk, what I am going to say is all these fools actually seem to be on this far side of the building. As you can see, they are all on the far side, which is actually, when we look at it, behind this door. And if we look closely, there is actually a sign on this door. I don't know how you pronounce it, but when you do translate this from German, it does actually say forbidden access. So it looks like they've already taken into consideration that past this point is too dangerous for people to go. So I will give them prompts for that. They have added in a nice safety sign and locked off the area. So whilst it is a medium here risk, we're actually going to put this as a 60 due to it being sectioned off. Unlike the presence of falling though, I cannot forgive the overall building stability. I will say, okay, this bit's been sectioned off. We'll give you a slight pass on that. But looking at the walls themselves, I mean, like we said earlier, that's a column. So that means this part of the building isn't stable. And you're starting to see, I mean, this is starting to crumble. That needs fixing. The cracks in the wall here and the cracks in the wall here, they're massive stability issues. More massive cracks in the walls and the ceilings. They could fall down at any time. And look, this pillar is nearly gone. That's not good. That is ready to fall off. Massive hole through the wall. I mean, you could see it as open plan now, but it's not great. The same with this one. And this is just about hanging on by thread. So I think we need to fix all of these issues here. So due to all this, I don't think I can give this a 60 like the falling risk that we identified. This one's gonna have to get a 50. Good thing this wall is nice and stable though. That looks like a solid wall. And what it... oh, what the f. Okay, we've identified the medium tier risks that we have to this building. Now we move on to the high tier threats that we have discovered here. Now the first one that I can see is this massive pillar that used to be here. Now I don't think I even have to say much about this, because look at this dude. What has happened to him? He has been impaled by it. So you could fall off that and you could end up just like this dude right here. Do you want to end up just like this dude? I would not. That is an impaling risk which could cause death. I'm sorry, but that is going to have to give you a rating of 10. Now the second and final high tier risk that I have come across is actually outside of the map, which are these barrels. They explode. That is not good for business. If you have explosives, that could cause issues. Now these are outside and not accessible to the general public stuck inside this map. And because of that, it would get a higher rating, probably around the 30. But I have also discovered there are live grenades just on the floor where people could walk. I could stand on one of these and set one of these off. That immediately bumps up the risk, and I am going to give it an overall of a 15. Okay, we can breathe now. We have gone through all the risks that Nacta and Toten could cause us. So now we are going to go through and see if we can find any safety benefits to the map that could actually help the player. The first thing we're going to talk about is actually the safety signs. Now, we know we've had a forbidden access safety sign here, which is good. We also have the likes of electrical safety signs warning us about the possibility of getting electric shocks, which are good. And even though the barrels are outside, you can actually see they have fire warning signs on them, and they also have whatever this says, explosive sign, I imagine, from, you know, the fact that it says explosive. So Nacta and Toten does get a +5 for their safety signs. Very well put out. On top of this, I did notice they also have gas masks in case of a chemical issue in the air. And whilst not specifically designed for the workplace, they do have helmets. And helmets can be provided to avoid any collisions to the head. See, once again, they have more helmets set up here for people. So realistically, those helmets could cause any head injuries, which will also give us a +5 rating on our safety side. Taking this into consideration, that means the hazards are as follows. We have tripping hazards for 75 points. We have hygiene at 70 points. Shrapnel at 90 points. Low tier burns at 85 points. Falling at 60 points. Building stability at 50 points. Impaling at 10 points. And explosions at 50 points. Now that we have all of this data, we can put them together and find out the overall mean rating that we get, which comes out to a 56.25. Now we're just going to round this down to 56 because it's easier. And we do have, of course, our two safety additions as well, being the PPE and the warning signs, which give us 5 each, taking us from a total of 56 up to a total of 66, meaning that Nachta and Toten overall gets a rating of 66. And that is it for our first ever Call of Duty Zombies safety check. Now this, I know, is something very, very different. And if you have enjoyed it, it would be great to know, because obviously that would mean that I should carry on with this series and make more of it. So if you want safety check to stick around and progress onto future maps, then let me know by leaving a like on the video. And whilst you're there, why not leave me a comment and tell me what could be added to improve our safety checks, or even just to say that you thought it was a new fun or goofy or even bad idea for a series. But that is all for Nachta and Toten. Next up, of course, would be Verruckt. So hopefully I shall see you in the future for the next episode of this series. But until then, I hope you have enjoyed, and I shall see you in the next video.